In this video, we'll be discussing a duplex renal pelvis and ureter. Now, this is the normal embryology. This is the mesonephric or the Wolfian duct. This mesonephric or Wolfian duct gives rise to a solitary or a single diverticulum, which I'm shading in pink. This is called a ureteric bud. This ureteric bud goes on to develop or to form into a ureter. Now, this ureteric bud, the development of this ureteric bud, it occurs at the same time as the development of the metanephric blastema into the kidney. So, this metanephric blastema which forms the kidney. It develops at the same time as the ureteric bud. And when the ureteric bud touches or when it comes in contact with the metanephric blastema, the development is initiated. So, you first have the primitive pelvis forming, then you have the chalices, and then you have the entire kidney being formed, in the entire collecting system of the kidney being formed. Now, a duplex renal pelvis and ureter is quite common. It is seen in approximately 1 in 150 births. It is more common unilaterally than bilaterally, more common on the left hand side. It is more common in girls than boys. It has two types, an incomplete type and a complete type. Now, in an incomplete type, what separates the incomplete, or what rather what differentiates the incomplete from the complete type, is the number of ureteric buds. So now in an incomplete type, we are going to see one ureteric bud. In a complete, we are going to see two ureteric buds. Let us discuss incomplete first. There is one ureteric bud which is formed, which bifurcates after. This after is a keyword. So it bifurcates after its initial development from the mesonephric duct. So to give you some perspective, let us look at the normal diagram. Now the ureteric bud is formed. So ureteric bud is formed. This was the mesonephric or the Wolfian duct. The ureteric bud is formed, and then I'll draw the whole thing again. Now this is the mesonephric duct. This is the ureteric bud. After it forms for some time, it then bifurcates. So because of the bifurcation, it looks like a Y shape. That's why it's called a Y ureter. Now this diagram is taken from Bailey and Love. You can see two renal pelvises, one and two, and you can see a Y shaped ureter. This is the incomplete type, and there is only one ureteric bud. One ureteric bud. Now let us look at the complete type. In complete type, there are two ureteric buds. So, to give you some perspective in the first diagram again, so let me draw this again. Now, this is your mesonephric duct. And two ureteric buds are formed. Therefore, you're going to see two ureters. One and two. Now among these two, one is normal and the other is abnormal. That is, in this one and two, one is normal and the other is abnormal. So this image taken from Langmann shows a complete duplication which has two ureters, one and two. This retrograde ureterogram taken from Bailey and Love, this image, it shows two renal pelvises and it shows two ureters. Now one of these are normal, the other is abnormal, but there are two separate ureteric buds. So coming back to this subdivision, you have incomplete and you have complete with one ureteric bud and two ureteric buds. Now, when there are two ureteric buds, one of them is abnormal and the other is normal. Now, this subdivision again, upper and lower, this upper and lower subdivision explained by this. So, now this is the kidney. This is the renal pelvis. This is the normal ureter. This is the normal ureter. It can either be upper or it can be lower. Upper or lower. This is upper. Upper is relative to the normal ureter. Or it can be lower, which is lower to, which is relatively lower to the normal ureter. So we were here. Now, what is this? What is the significance of this upper and lower ureter? That is, whether it drains the upper part of the kidney or the lower part of the kidney related to the normal one. That is because when we do a cystoscopy, now this is a normal cystoscopy. So you can see this is the trigone. You can see the right ureter, left ureter. This is another image of a normal cystoscopy showing right and left with a trigone. These two images are taken from R.K. Mishra sir's YouTube channel. This is a ureteric orifice. This is the right hand side. And this is the left ureteric orifice. This is the left hand side. Now, when you're doing cystoscopy for a patient in whom you're suspecting a duplicated renal pelvis or ureter, you will see three orifices, one right, left, and one abnormal one. Two normal ones, right hand side, left hand side, and the abnormal one. Now, as we said initially, it is more commonly seen on the left hand side than the right hand side. So now let us look at this diagram. Let us look at the left hand side. So this is the right, left, and a trigone. You will see two openings. You will see two openings on the left hand side. Let me make a bifurcation. So this right one, forget it for this moment. And let us look at the left hand side. We will see two openings on the left hand side. This is the normal one. And we'll see one more opening. It can be either here or it can be here. Now, what is the importance of this normal opening? It ends in the correct site in the trigone and therefore does not reflux. The abnormal one, it can either be a lower position or a higher position. What is this low and high? This is the lower and high. Lower, upper or higher. Now, this lower and higher position is determined by a rule, as in where the ureter opens. In a completely duplicated renal pelvis and ureter, where the abnormal ureter opens into the urinary bladder is governed or determined by a rule called the Weigert-Mayer rule. This rule states that in a complete duplication, again I am reiterating, it is not in incomplete duplication, it is seen only in complete duplication. In complete duplication, the upper abnormal or the lower abnormal, so I'll add this word abnormal over here, the upper abnormal and the lower abnormal, they have their own ureters because it is complete and each ureter has its own orifice. So now supposing if it is an upper abnormal moiety, the ureteric orifice of the upper abnormal moiety, it is inferior medial relative to the normal ureteric opening. And if it is a lower abnormal moiety, it opens, or the ureteric orifice of the lower abnormal moiety is superior lateral when compared to the normal ureteric orifice. So let us look at the lower butt first. Now the lower bud, it drains the lower pole of the kidney. What do you mean by lower pole? We'll come back to this diagram. This is the lower pole, which is draining into the lower part of the kidney. Now it drains the lower pole of the kidney. It enters the bladder. After it enters the bladder, it has a short submucosal tunnel. And then it ends superolateral compared to the normal orifice. So if this is the normal orifice, right and left in yellow, the abnormal one will drain superolaterally to the normal one. This is left, this is superolaterally, this is superolateral compared to the normal opening. Now because it has a short submucosal tunnel, it causes a reflux, or it causes a vesicoureteric reflux, and it is more commonly seen in children. Now, there is one more important point. In a child, if the child is presenting with VUR or vesicoureteric reflux, some cases the VUR may spontaneously resolve, some cases it may not spontaneously resolve. Now, if it is due to if the VUR is due to a duplicated renal pelvis or ureter, it has a lower chance of spontaneously resolving than due to another cause. So to reiterate, if it is a lower bud, by lower bud, we mean this lower bud. This lower bud will always end superolateral to the normal ureteric orifice. Now, what do we mean by an upper bud? Now, when I was studying this, I got quite confused, which is why I'm drawing this kidney again and again to show what is upper and what is lower. Now, this is the normal ureter, and in an upper bud means relative to this. Now, this upper bud, it will end the ureteric orifice of this. It ends, as you can see in this yellow dot over here, it ends inferomedially. It ends inferomedially. It ends inferomedially compared to the normal ureteric orifice. And the symptoms of the upper and the lower bud also are also different. So now, in the lower bud, we had seen that it causes VUR of vesicular reflux. In an upper bud, it causes obstruction. Now, this is remembered by a very useful mnemonic which says upper obstructs and a lower refluxes. So, to give you an analogy, supposing you are working in a hostile environment and you have a horrible boss. So, the upper person obstructs, he is hampering your progress. And the lower rungs, I mean, because they cannot progress and they cannot move ahead in life, they are refluxing. So, to come back, so because it is an upper moiety, it is going to cause obstruction. This obstruction will lead to dysplasia. I'll use a better color. This obstruction will lead to dysplasia. This dysplasia then causes scarring. Scarring happens of the upper moiety. So now this is remembered by this important mnemonic or a useful mnemonic: upper obstructs, lower refluxes. Now we've been talking so much about upper moiety, lower moiety. So now let us revise. So now supposing a patient comes to me in the OPD and I do a cystoscopy. This is the urinary bladder. And we see the two normal orifices, the right and the left. And this is the trigone. Now, supposing the abnormal ureteric orifice is over here, this means it is inferomedial. This means it is inferomedial. Inferomedial, as you can see over here, is upper bud. This means if it is inferomedial, it will drain into an upper moiety. If it is an upper moiety, the mnemonic is upper obstructs. So you'll get obstruction, which will cause dysplasia and scarring of upper moiety. Now, supposing another patient comes to you in the OPD, you do a cystoscopy, this is the bladder. You see the two normal ureteric orifices. This is the trigone. But in this case, I'll use a different color this time. But in this case, the ureteric orifice is over here. This means it is superolateral. So which moiety will the superolateral have? According to Weigert-Meyer rule, superolateral will have lower moiety. Now, how I remember this is L for lower and L for lateral. And then one more mnemonic, which is LS, that is low society. So you'll have a lower, you'll see it in a lower moiety. To reconstruct this mnemonic, to reconstruct both these cystoscopies, let us look at it again and we'll draw this entire thing again. So this is scenario one. You have right, you have left, and you have the patient who, and you can see an abnormal opening here. This abnormal opening, it is inferomedial. If it is inferomedial, it means it is an upper moiety. If it is an upper moiety, it will cause obstruction of the upper moiety. Sorry, it will cause, the upper moiety will cause obstruction, it will cause scarring of the upper moiety. Now, how do you remember whether this is upper or lower? What I use in my head is a very silly mnemonic, although useful mnemonic. So, this is medial, M, which looks like an inverted U. So, I come to the mnemonic upper. Now, in scenario 2, I'll use a different color. Now, in scenario 2, I saw that the opening is, it is superolateral. So, if it is superolateral, which moiety is it? It is L. L for lower moiety. And the lower moiety, the symptom is reflux. Thank you.